Thanks. Well, cheers and applause may have filled St. Peter's Square last night, but the celebrations go hand in hand with criticism. The new pontiff has many daunting tasks ahead as the Roman Catholic Church tackles sex abuse scandals, internal bickering, and growing secularism in Europe.
What reform, if any, does the Catholic Church need? That is the major question which the new Pope has to answer. Few are expecting changes on hot-button issues such as gay marriage or abortion, but on others, such as the ordination of women or allowing priests to marry, change may be closer at hand. The scandal surrounding sexual abuse committed by priests is also an open wound waiting to be healed. Benedict XVI promised a zero-tolerance approach and cooperation with legal inquiries. But many dioceses, such as Los Angeles, have failed to get to the bottom of the abuse, thus tarnishing the church's reputation further. Persecution of Christians and increased dialogue with Islam will also come on the new pontiff's radar. In the north of Nigeria and in Kenya and Iraq, they've been victims of deadly attacks by Islamic extremists. The third major target for reform is the Vatican itself. It's been criticized in some quarters as opaque, secretive, and corrupt. Benedict XVI pushed for greater transparency and at the end of his term saw his own butler on trial for having leaked documents about the Vatican's internal workings. They revealed a dysfunctional church hierarchy riven by infighting, yet one more issue for Francis to consider.